talking truth and now they're thinking traumatic's mad. I'm talking truth though, the truth is I'm a savage lad. Stupid, so I kill them using tragic facts. We need to be responsible and take the planet back. Listen, human beings must be blinded by cataracts. So I'm tying razors on my hands and giving them happy slaps. People panic and the place
is... Yo, it's the Givinator, and in this video I'm going to be going through some things that all noobs do in Call of Duty Black Ops 4. This is hopefully going to help you improve massively at Call of Duty, especially if you're a beginner getting into the game. And even if you are a more experienced player, you can always use this and get some advice from any of the points that I make up in this video. But yo, let's get straight into it. The first and most common thing that all noobs do is running around corners. Now, running around corners is a very stupid thing, and I was guilty of it back when I first got into Call of Duty, and I'm pretty sure most people do it. So why it's so bad is because you can never know whether there's someone there or not. There could be someone using ghost, so they're not on your mini map, and there's just so many situations where there could be someone there, so it's not worth making the risk of running around it. You've literally got to tell yourself that unless you've looked around that corner, there's someone there. You've got to check it. So you've got to aim down your sights, and something that I recommend you do is using stock. Now, what stock's going to allow you to do is move faster while you're aiming down your sights, because a lot of people, they want to rush as hard as they possibly can, and that's their excuse for not aiming down sights around corners. So if you put on stock, it's a bit faster, so it makes it a bit more comfortable. That's what I do, and I like it. Doesn't affect my rushing playstyle at all. It really helps me out, and it also allows you to win gunfights a lot easier because you can strafe in mid gunfight, which is really good. If you don't know what strafing is, that's just where you move left and right whilst you're shooting someone, making yourself harder to hit. But yeah, aiming down your sights around corners is absolutely essential to doing well. I can assure you, if you are guilty of running around corners, as soon as you do this tip, your KD is going to go up massively. Just think about all those times where you run around the corner and there's just someone there and you always die to them. If you stop getting those deaths and you get more kills because you're killing those people around the corners, oh my, you're going to be getting loads of kills. Another tip for like running around corners and stuff is, if you are so rushy and you're stubborn and you don't want to change it and start aiming around corners, what you can do is put gung-ho on. Now, gung-ho reduces the sprint out time, which means that you can pull up your gun faster after sprinting, which is very helpful. So if there's another person on the other team sprinting around the same corner that you are, it means that you're going to pull your gun up before them, which is pretty good, and you can start shooting before them. So that's really quite good, and that's going to help you out a lot and help you to actually like win some of those gunfights. It's still not as good as aiming around the corners, but it's a little bit of help, so it's better than not using it at all. It's literally like a couple milliseconds, but that little couple milliseconds can be the difference between getting a kill and not getting a kill. But anyways, yeah, that's the first common mistake that people make. Moving on to the second one, and that is reloading after every kill. Now, I used to do this as well. Like, these are all things that I've done. Like, don't be ashamed if you do these things. Just see it as that you can improve, because I was once at this point. Every single Call of Duty player was once at this point. Like, you look at the pros, Optic, Scumpy, Nature, all those dudes, they were doing the same thing. I don't even know if they play COD anymore, but they're the only pros I know. But yeah, so that's everyone's done it basically, so just don't be ashamed of it. You can get better. So reloading after every kill is a very bad habit, and I understand why people do it, because you're constantly, you're just thinking ahead. You think it's a smart thing to do at the time because you're like, yo, I need my bullets so that I can kill some next dudes. But when you just reactively get into the bad habit of literally every time you shoot someone, you reload, if two more people come, if three more people come, you're absolutely screwed, because you're just a sitting duck that's reloading his gun and can't do anything about it, and it will literally get you killed so many times. So what I want you to do is just be more comfortable with having less ammo in your magazines. Like, you can easily get a couple kills with like 20 bullets left in your mag. You can even get a kill with 10 bullets left in your mag. Like, you can do that. So just don't be stressed out about reloading. It's not like a good thing to do all the time. You've just got to be patient and just be really aware of the game. Try not to get too distracted by like external things like your phone, YouTube, stuff like that. Because I know a lot of people, like, they listen to music and they're texting people at the same time as playing, trying to multitask. But yo, you've just got to stay focused, because the chances are, if you're looking at your mini map and stuff, you're going to know that there's more, like, you're going to have a higher chance of knowing whether there's more people where the dude you've just killed is coming from, so you'll know whether it's right or wrong to reload. But for a lot of people, they're literally just in the habit of reloading after every kill, so you've got to break that habit. You've just got to be very conscious about it when you're playing, so you can figure out when to stop. And like, it's a pretty tough one, but it won't take take you long at all once you actually realise that you're doing it. You'll stop it for sure. I mean, even sometimes I get guilty of it, like when I'm getting tired, it's like 12 o'clock in the morning, I'm trying to grind. I will start like reloading after every kill and it'll start screwing me over. But once you stop, you're literally just going to start be stacking up those kills and your KD is going to increase massively. You're going to start getting those score streaks and it's going to be a good time. The next thing that all noobs do is not centering. Now you're probably like, what the hell is centering? So I'm going to go through it right now. So centering is where you get the crosshairs that are on your screen, those four little dashes in this shape. It's when you get that and you align it with the enemy that you're about to kill. Now a lot of people, they simply see someone and they think, oh, I'm going to aim down my sights. And then once they've aimed down their sights, they then drag over to the player. And why that's bad is because when you're doing that, you actually move a lot slower. You move way faster when you're not aiming down your sights, meaning that you're going to be faster moving and locking onto that target. When you're aiming down your sights, your sensitivity is slowed quite a lot. So if you're just aiming in like a couple meters away from the person and dragging over to them, you're literally wasting so much time. You could drag over to them and then aim down your sights on them and kill them way faster. And as I say, Call of Duty is a game completely based off of time. If you can reduce the time in your gunfights, you're literally just going to massively improve your chances of winning those gunfights. Like if you can just get that little edge over your enemy, you're literally guaranteed the kill unless you've got dodgy internet. But if you've got decent internet, yo, you're sorted. You're going to be getting so many kills when you start centering properly. And also with centering, why it's really good is because you can start doing this technique called snapping. And that is where you really abuse the aim assist in Call of Duty to give you the maximum amount of assist when you're going for those kills. And it's literally just going to snap you onto people. So when you put that crosshair on people and you aim down your sight, that aim assist is literally just going to lock you onto people. You can shoot your five bullets, get your kill, and then move on to the next person. And it's just unaiming down your sights and then moving to the next target, aiming down your sights. And honestly, once you start doing that, that is when you start getting really good and you can start thinking about getting nuclear medals and the real high score streaks in the game. The next mistake that I see a lot of noobs making is actually with like the new healing process that's in Black Ops 4. So in this game, you don't actually automatically regenerate your health. You have to give yourself like a stim shot that actually heals you and brings back your health up to the max level. And there's a lot of mistakes around this mechanic that noobs make. So there's a couple situations. So for example, you can have the same kind of thing as people that reload after every kill. There's the people that regen after every kill, even when it's not like a necessary thing. Like if someone's only hit you with one bullet and there's like three people in front of you, you're better off going for the triple kill than healing, because it's not worth it for the extra couple health that you're gonna get. You're better off going for those kills. So it's just all about being situational and figure out what is the best thing to do at that time. Because a lot of people, as I said, they're just reactive players. They don't think about what they're doing. They just instinctively do it. And when you're doing that, you're not thinking. You're not being as smart as you possibly can. So when you can see two people in front of you and one of them shoots you, don't heal yourself. That is so stupid. Get the double kill and you'll be Gucci, and then you can reload. You can regenerate your health after that. Another thing is people that just don't regenerate at all. Like you've got to be doing it. If you get bodied by two kids, they push you and you're like one hit, the chance of you killing another person when you're one hit is like, it's so slim. It's not going to happen. So you've just got to remember that you do need to regenerate your health. I've seen it so many times, even with good players. I've been in streams where I've seen them, they're like on really high kill streaks and they just forget to regenerate their health. So they're literally challenging people with like half health, and when they're like a couple kills off a nuclear, I'm like, what are you doing? But when you get into like those high pressure situations, you kind of forget about it. But I can assure you, once you start getting into the habit of it, you won't forget it, and it'll just become ingrained into you, and you'll just get this like situational awareness when you know it's right and when you know it's wrong to be healing yourself. The final mistake that noobs do that I'm going to cover in this video is not looking at your minimap enough. And it's so like essential for you to do in Black Ops 4 because of the fog of war. Now, if you don't know what the fog of war is, I'll put some gameplay up in the video now. And it's basically that little glow that you see around your icon on the mini map. And in that glow, when anybody goes into the radius, the area of that circle, they show up on your mini map. So it is so vital that you're looking at your mini map all the time, especially if you're in like a really close quarters combat situation. You're in a building with lots of rooms around it which people could potentially be in. all of those people could like be pinging on your fog of war and you would literally be able to notice them, and they can see you as well. So if you're not looking at your mini map and your enemies are, you're literally at a straight disadvantage because they're going to be seeing you when they're up close. And this fog of war, it kind of acts as like a sixth sense. It's not going to be like massively game changing, but it's going to allow you to know when there's people sneaking up on you, which I absolutely love, because there's nothing worse than getting shot in the back when you think you've got an area locked down and then some little sneaky kid comes along and then shoots you in the back. But with this fog of war, you can find them quite easily because they ping up on your minimap. So it's so essential that you're looking at that. And just as well in general, when you're seeing people shooting their guns, it's so like you need to be able to know where they are on the map. Otherwise, you're literally running around like a headless chicken without a game plan, with no direction to where you're going to be playing. You won't know where the spawns are. It's just so essential that you get good at looking at the minimap. I will do a video like dedicated to how to use the minimap most effectively, but all I'm going to say is you should be looking at the minimap around 70% of the time and then at the game the rest of the time, because it is seriously vital to making you a good player. As well, like all of your teammates have a fog of war which you can see, so you basically have like half a UAV up all the time. It's not like 100% efficient, it's not going to be picking everyone up, but it's really good. So yeah, just look at your minimap. Most noobs don't even realize what their minimap's showing them, but when you get UAVs and stuff, it shows your enemies on it. So it literally tells you where they are so you can go and find them. It's so, so good. So just start looking at your minimap. And honestly, that's probably the best thing. Like if you're someone that's not looking at your minimap, start it now. And you'll see yourself just improving so much day in, day out. Every single day, you'll just be improving. You'll be getting better and better. You'll be getting longer streaks, a higher KD. You'll be dying less. And it'll be a great time. But yo, if you found this video helpful and you liked it, be sure to subscribe to the channel. Also, if you could drop a like on it, that would be much appreciated. Helps me to get more views and stuff, which obviously I want because I'm a YouTuber, and that would just mean a lot to me. So yeah, it's been the Gibbinator. I'll see you in the next video, lads. Peace.